What exactly do you know about Vikings except the incredibly inaccurate depictions of Thor and even other movies and TV shows? Let's take a look at what it was really like to be a Saxon and all the things they influenced in our society. 23. The Horned Helmet Myth. While many of us associate Vikings with wearing that signature helmet with horns, it might surprise you to know that no Viking ever really wore that kind of headgear into battle. The main reason being that the horns make it impractical to be doing battle and have something that heavy and stable on your head. So where did this myth start? Religious leaders were known to don these helmets during ceremonies, so maybe that's it. 22. Running through the blizzard. All those trips you took to the ski resort in the winter and all the fun you had there should be credited to the Vikings. They were, after all, the ones who invented the Western-style skis most of you are familiar with. There's been other kind of skis that show up all around the world throughout history, although the ones the Vikings invented were the ones that influenced modern Western culture. 21. Inventing bristled combs. How else do you think the Vikings kept all those long locks and long beards intact? Why, they made combs, of course. The bristled kind you're very familiar with. Lots of other historical cultures have their own variations of combs. But you've got to admit, the Viking version looks the closest to modern-day combs we use. Their brushes and combs were made for both men and women, since it was a big part of their culture to grow everything long. Plus, it was the medieval times. Everyone's hair was long. 20. Viking women's rights. While the Viking civilization was clearly male-dominant like most places, when you compare the lifestyle women led to other European societies, women had it slightly better in the Norse traditions. Women could own property as well as manage land they inherited, while in other places, law dictated this could only be rewarded to men. They also allowed women to go on voyages, though they could not fight in battles. 19. Navigating the seas. As one culture, they made a reputation for themselves as one of the best explorers in history. And by best, we mean one of the most technologically advanced explorers history has ever seen. A lot of this efficient traveling is due to their advances in navigation and the way they built their ships. In the 8th century, the Viking invention of the keel changed seafaring forever, giving the vessel more stability on the waters and the shape of the longboat, helping them be flexible in their directions. 18. From wood to war. Once upon a time, Vikings could only use their axes to chop wood. But wait, what if you could use it in battle? That's the question Vikings must have asked themselves, and so they went ahead and made a revolutionary battle axe. The kind you see in all those medieval movies and video games. The Viking axe includes a hook so that you could grab your enemy by the foot or his shield. Gnarly. 17. All the places they conquered and founded. Because of their efficiency in voyaging and all their neat weapons, it was easy for them to get anywhere and take over. You probably guessed, but the Vikings were the ones who found places like Iceland and Greenland, with Greenland thriving once upon a time. It also looks like Vikings had a significant influence on how Russia developed, with historians theorizing that Russians came from Sweden, meaning they might even be the same peoples. 16. The Viking diet. When it comes to dieting, fads come and go. One of the most recent ones you may or may not remember was the Viking diet. About 3 to 4 years ago, health gurus and companies were advocating the Viking diet, a way of eating that the History Channel described as surprisingly efficient. Vikings had a diverse diet, consisting of things like meat, breads, seafood, as well as lots of fruit and vegetables. They were, however, also prone to getting worms, so it wasn't exactly the perfect way to feast. 15. The medieval warm period. Who knew global warming could help some people see the world more easily? Hundreds of years ago, a meteorological event called the medieval warm period lasted from about 950 to 1250. The increased temperatures in the northern hemisphere helped melt the ice and make it easier for Vikings to make their way across the water. The warmth also let people thrive in places where it could be too cold to do so otherwise. 14. All those long stories. Although historians are in agreement that Viking sagas don't really depict history in an accurate way, it does make for an entertaining read, which was probably their purpose. What these sagas do tell us are that Vikings were big on the fantasy genre, and because of all the ones that were written during the 12th to 14th centuries, it had influenced the way modern fantasy genre developed. 13. Thank them for camping. You're probably thinking how simple a Viking tent looks. It's just a bunch of sticks making triangles. True. The Viking design for a tent is very simple, and because it is, their tents prove practical and efficient. The platform at the bottom and its angles made it quite strong and resilient to the harsh, cold weather they endured. 12. Crystal sunstones. That's not an ice cube or an extremely clear block of salt. What you're looking at is a sunstone. one we can thank the Vikings for making. The stones, made of calcite crystal, appear to have been utilized as a navigational tool. Though, nothing's too certain. Researchers guess they were used to navigate since many sunstones were discovered amongst the sunken Alderney ship that sank in 1592. The shape lets it polarize the sunlight, so if you hold it up, the sailor could be able to figure out which way is east or west, no matter what the conditions are. 11. Paying those fines. Would you believe it if we told you that in order for Vikings to avoid bloodshed, they made laws where you had to pay fines if you broke them? While other cultures were fine with the blood feuds, it seems the Vikings thought just paying something extra would solve the problem, a practice people held onto centuries later. Even though they're certainly not the first society to impose fines, their particular practice is what modern societies developed it from. 10. Planting the flag. Guess who made it to the New World from Europe first? Not Christopher Columbus, will tell you that much. He didn't even mean to go there. About 400 years before Columbus supposedly discovered North America, the Vikings sailed from Europe first. It looks as though there's evidence of Viking Native American interaction, something we don't often hear about. Leif Erikson himself planted a flag in Newfoundland way before Columbus set out for spices. 9. The surprising amount of hygiene. The way we depict Vikings in pop culture would make you think they were covered in grime and dirt from all the battles they had in muddy terrain. Yet historical evidence shows they were actually really hygienic. Yeah, the things you learn, right? Vikings not only made bristled combs, they could fashion ear cleaners from animal bones, create razors, and even tweezers, with most of them taking a bath at least once a week. Which, for back then, was an admirable record. 8. The social classes. You might think Vikings were all running around with axes, drinking mead and screaming and yelling, but they did have divided social classes. At the top were, of course, kings. The nobility below them were referred to as jarls, which also consisted of people like priests. Then you had the freemen, or the Karls, a group allowed to own property and build land on them. Think of them as the middle class. At the bottom rung were the thralls, the slaves of society. 7. Keeping them safe. So what's so special about a Viking shield compared to everyone else's? For one, their flat-faced structure and wood material make them flexible and light to carry. Light, however, does not mean weak. Their shields and its flexible nature made it harder for the shields to shatter during battle, letting swords get stuck in them instead of destroying it. 6. Lots of magnets. So apparently, there's a plentiful amount of lodestone or mineral magnetite to be found in Scandinavia, and Vikings thought it would be a good idea to use it to help them find their way around the world. Turns out, a magnetic compass was a brilliant idea, and a device that we would continue to use to this day. The rest of Europe didn't have magnetic compasses until they traded with China, though the Vikings had it themselves for a long time before that. 5. More ways to go places. Think that all those sunstones, magnetic compasses, and advanced shipbuilding was enough for Vikings? Guess what? It wasn't, because they also used a little thing called a sun compass to help them figure out where they were going. For long distance voyages, Vikings would use a little wood thing called a sun compass, allowing them to navigate through a sun's shadow board. What this did help determine was the ship's latitude, since it would be able to tell you the sun's height above the equator this way. 4. The Anglo-Saxon Horde. Not only did Vikings leave us all these influences on our modern technology and laws, but they also left behind some really neat artifacts. Such as what, you may ask? Such as over 5,000 silver coins that were made during the time of King Canute. That's between the late 900s AD to 1035 AD. The coins were discovered in Buckinghamshire, England, said to be worth about 1.35 million British pounds. 3. The city of Dublin. We owe a lot of places to the Saxons. One you might not have guessed has Viking origins is that of Dublin. The capital city of Ireland was founded in 841 AD, the time of the first recorded settlement there. Back then, it was called Dublin, meaning Blackpool, not to be confused with the Blackpool in the UK. For nearly 300 years, the Vikings held control of Dublin until the Irish took over in 1014. 2. The English language. While Ireland maintained most of its Irish roots in their language, you cannot say the same for the English language. Vikings came to what is now modern-day England all the way back in 793 AD. Since then, they left a permanent mark on this island, with a lot of native English people actually being more Saxon by blood. Not only that, but the English language strayed away from its Old English origins and melded with the Old Norse language. 1. What we know about them. At this point, we've told you a load of stuff about the Vikings. Don't you think it's interesting, however, that a lot of what we know about Vikings didn't come from the Vikings themselves? It seems they lacked a consistency when it came to keeping written records. That, or we can't find them. Instead, historians have gathered a lot of from what their enemies wrote about them, since they just had so many enemies. Later societies couldn't really study the Vikings until the 20th century, once we started discovering more of their ancient artifacts. Which of these surprised you the most? Who knew that with all the things they left behind, there's still so much more to learn about Vikings? If you like videos like this, don't forget to like and subscribe. And before you leave, leave a comment on your favorite Viking tidbit you learned today.